Hi guys, Guitar Interactive NAMM 2020. I'm still with Ben, John Doe Guitars.
How are you?
I'm very well, mate. We're both discussing how tired we are. We are a pair of filthy Brits who aren't quite on American time yet.
It's true.
But so we're not delirious. No, I don't think so. But we have got a whole raft of really cool guitars to talk about. I'm going to step out this way. Do you want to talk to us a little bit about the whole concept of the guitar and your history?
Yeah.
And then we'll get into each model?
Let's do that.
Cool. So how did this all come about?
Yeah, so start at the very beginning. I'm a screenwriter by trade. I write TV and films with my wife. So we've been doing it for 25 years now. At the same time, when I was a teenager, I started modding and customizing guitars. And so a couple of years ago, I had the idea of, I always loved guitars with stories, like B.B. King, Lucille, Pearly Gates, Billy Gibbons. We know the stories, we've heard them many, many, many times before, but we love how a guitar can somehow become a holy relic when it has a story to it, so it's elevated. Yeah. And so what I wanted to do is treat the guitar, my guitars, is the same thing, which is not just make guitars, but give them a backstory, somehow makes them special, almost becoming artifacts. So I started building in 2017, and I sold my first run at the London Guitar Show. I thought, this is working, people know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
People were saying they're more gallery pieces, they should be in art galleries, a bit flattering.
But
what gallery would do that, I don't know. But I did another run, and then when I did my London Guitar Show in 2018, Dennis came over with a very quizzical look on his face, going, but he really enjoyed the stories I'd written that go with the guitars, and he loved all the small details that I go into in an almost OCD.
Yeah.
I shouldn't, but I do. He loved what I did and said, asked me, would I do a range for vintage?
Yeah.
And I said, yeah.
Well, sweet.
Nothing better to do.
And lo and behold,
here we are.
We have a range.
Yeah.
Let's talk. So let's start with, Lucky Betty's.
Yeah, so what I've loved about this is I came across a small bit of footage of some 50s group of women who were daredevils in 1950s. Uh-huh. And there's footage of them crashing jalopies, tying each other to the bonnet of cars, driving through Wings of Fire. And I just love that. So basically I've invented a story of Lucky Betty, who had a troupe who toured America doing stunts. And her piece de resistance would be, she would ride around the Wall of Death on a guitar playing songs until the cable popped out. And I love that. So. This is kind of modeled on the jalopies that had all the special graphics. And on the back, we have a message from her husband, Larry. May all your jumps end on two wheels.
That is so, it's so kind of cool, man.
The kind of nonsense I do.
Yes,
yeah, so that's what we come with, two versions of that one.
Mate, that's someone else. Like, as guitar concepts go, that is the deepest and most involved backstory for an user I think I've ever heard. And they all have stories, right?
Yeah, they do.
So what about this guy?
This one. So I've got a few tattoos. My wife's got way tattoos.
Yeah.
Brilliant. So I also understood from that is that people who love tattoos go to certain tattooists.
Uh-huh.
They collect them.
Yeah.
So I love the idea of telling a story of a sailor who, when he travels around the world, he stops up at ports to have a tattoo done.
Uh-huh.
But when you've got your whole body covered, you've nowhere else to go. So he took his guitar to tattoo parlors and he's collected the tattoos on his actual guitar.
That's wicked.
So because he's a sailor, there's a very secret language of tattoos.
All
so
right.
Certain tattoos mean certain things, which I won't tell you because that's for people to find out themselves.
Man, that is so...
A star means you've travelled so many thousand miles.
Oh, so it's as deep as that? Like,
yeah, there's a lot of superstition.
Wow.
So I've done that. This is designed by a tattooist in Lewis called John Washington. He did that for me. That's an old plate I found on an old warship. So I had that made. So things like that, really.
That's unbelievable.
You've got to do something.
Oh, cool, man.
I should say as well that each... Yeah. Each guitar comes with a case candy I've designed, because when people buy a guitar, they open the case, they go, wow!
Yeah.
They lift the guitar up and want to dive in and see what case candy you get, which I understand because I do it myself.
Yeah.
So each guitar has its own case candy I've designed.
Yeah.
So for example, this is a Punkcaster. The story behind this is a guy who, a teenager, is very self-destructive, was booted out of his hometown, traveled middle America like a tumbleweed, ended up in Times Square, early 1980s, working at a porno theatre by day and in a rocking punk band at night. So this is what I've done. It's basically a telly and a Strat smashed together, and it comes with stickers you can put on, again, tied to the porno theatres at the time.
Oh,
and then if I flip it around, I've got Sexy Times there. And then it gets very adult on the back.
Oh, really?
Ew. Yeah. So he's got his own lawyer's card there. And then lots of graffiti from his groupies.
Oh, that's like a bathroom door.
Yeah.
That's, wow.
And I had to remove some rude things.
For the show.
For the show.
Make it PG-13. Family friendly.
But it should be a triple X.
Oh,
so
dude.
If you want to add rude pictures.
You can add your own rude pictures.
Exactly.
That is phenomenal. So,
yeah.
Like, I mean, I've genuinely, like, blown away by how deep these concepts are, man.
Nick, you're too kind.
We won't go into every one of them because we're going to let people go to your website and we're going to let them discover it for themselves. But, man, super cool. Definitely the most interesting guitars I've seen in the show so far.
Oh, you're so kind.
Oh, man, yeah. And a lovely guy, no less. So, man, seriously, okay. So where can people find out more about what you do is through Vintage Guitars.
Or the Joe Doe's Guitars website.
There you go.
It's the same blog.
Fantastic. Wicked.
Hey.
Magic. Guys, Joe Doe Guitars, this is Ben. My name's Nick. Our NAMM 2020 coverage continues.